Ever felt like you're living in the shadows of someone else? Well, that's the case for today's dinosaur, the Atrociraptor. This dinosaur has been living in the shadows of its much more famous relative for many decades, the Velociraptor. Compared to other raptors, Atrociraptor had some features and adaptations that made it different and anything but ordinary. But even with these adaptations, it has never been properly showcased to the world, so now it's time to give this pint-sized predator the spotlight it deserves. In 1995, Wayne Marshall, a fossil collector with experience at the Royal Tyrrell Museum, made a big discovery in Alberta, Canada. While exploring the Horseshoe Canyon formation, he found jaw fragments and teeth sticking out of a hillside just 5 kilometers from the museum. This find would turn out to be a major scientific breakthrough. Marshall carefully dug up the fossil and brought it to paleontologist Philip J. Curry at the museum. The specimen, labeled RTMP95.166.1, included parts of the jaw and teeth. At first, they thought it might be another dromaeosaurid, which is a family of swift and agile dinosaurs like the Velociraptor. But as Curry and his team looked closer, they realized it was something completely new. They noticed that the specimen contained features that set it apart from other known dromaeosaurids. In 2004, after years of careful study, Curry and his colleague David Verricchio announced the discovery and named the specimen Atrociraptor marshalli. This name translates to savage thief and was used to describe its predatory nature and honor its discoverer. The discovery of Atrociraptor marshalli was a big deal in paleontology. It made scientists rethink how they classified dinosaurs and showed that prehistoric ecosystems were more complex than they first thought. It opened up new questions about dinosaur evolution and caught the attention of both researchers and dinosaur fans. What made this dinosaur so special? How did it live in late Cretaceous Alberta? These are all some of the questions I will try to give you the answer to in this video. But first, please give this video a like to inform even more people about this spectacular dinosaur, and subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed it so far. Imagine stepping back 70 million years to a world where Atrociraptor ruled. The landscape that later would become Alberta looked both familiar and strange. The air was warm and thick, about 15 degrees Celsius. This wasn't the Alberta we know today. It was Laramidia, a continent full of prehistoric life sitting 8 degrees north of where it is today. Here, you would have been surrounded by a lush, wet environment. The ground would have been soft and soggy, part of a big coastal plain or river system. You would have seen a mix of different habitats everywhere you looked. The plants would have been a blend of the familiar and odd. Tall conifers like pines, redwoods, and cypresses dominated, looking a lot like modern forests. But under them, ferns and other ancient plants created an undergrowth that felt historic. When it comes to animals, it would have been something you have never witnessed before. This habitat made a home for a lot of different dinosaur species. Herds of Edmontosaurus grazed alongside big, frilled Pachyrhinosaurus. But these weren't the only giants lurking in the area. Albertosaurus, a huge tyrannosaurid theropod dinosaur, would have also been lurking amongst the trees on a hunt for some food. All of these animals are of much bigger size than Atrociraptor, so that raises the question, how did this small predator survive and thrive among these giants? The answer seems to be in its special features and adaptations that were perfectly suited for a life in the Cretaceous world. As mentioned earlier, Atrociraptor's name means savage thief, and it lived up to that title. At just 2 feet or 60 centimeters tall and 6.5 feet or 2 meters long, this wolf-sized dinosaur was small but deadly. Its light body and strong legs made it a great runner, able to chase down smaller dinosaurs or escape from bigger predators. These features, together with other adaptations, made it perfectly adapted for hunting in the late Cretaceous period. One of the more interesting things about Atrociraptor was its teeth. Unlike other dromaeosaurids, Atrociraptor's teeth were relatively straight. To compensate for that difference, the teeth grew at an angle to the jawline, creating a row of teeth that could grip and tear flesh incredibly well. The teeth in its upper jaw were narrow and blade-like, tilting backwards and down. Unusually for its family, all of Atrociraptors' teeth were about the same size, which hints at a special hunting style. But it was another adaptation, very different from other raptors, that made it stand out even more, and that was its short, tall skull. This unique head shape and dental structure gave it a strong bite, letting it crunch through bone and tough hide easily. When Atrociraptor bit down, those angled teeth would sink in deep, making it almost impossible for prey to escape. These adaptations were what helped Atrociraptor survive in the tough Cretaceous world. Its unique head shape and special teeth structure suggest it could attack prey larger than you'd expect for its size. This small dinosaur carved out its own place in a world of giants, showing that effective predators can come in small packages. In the world of paleontology, Atrociraptor is a bit of an oddball, a dinosaur that doesn't fit easily into the family tree. This identity crisis could change how we think about dinosaur evolution. Classifying dinosaurs is more than just giving names to ancient bones. It's about finding the right place in a complex system that helps scientists understand how different species relate to each other and how they evolved over time. For Atrociraptor, this classification has been anything but straightforward. At first, scientists put it in the Velociraptorinae subfamily. Later, they thought it might belong with the Sauronitholestinae instead. This subfamily includes dinosaurs like Sauronitholestes, which lived in the same area as Atrociraptor. The matter is an ever-ongoing debate, and scientists are still arguing about where this savage thief really belongs. But why has this been so hard for so long, and what is the actual problem? The truth is simple. We don't have many Atrociraptor fossils. With only a few fragments to work with, it's hard to figure out how it relates to other dinosaurs. It's like trying to complete a huge jigsaw puzzle with just a handful of pieces. Even so, the most recent studies agree that Atrociraptor belongs with the Sauronitholestinae subfamily. This means it was probably more closely related to Sauronitholestes than to Velociraptor. Some researchers even think Atrociraptor might have hunted larger prey, which adds an interesting twist to its story. This debate about Atrociraptor shows some big challenges in paleontology. As we find new fossils and develop better research tools, our understanding of dinosaur evolution keeps changing. For example, scientists are now using CT scans to learn more about Atrociraptor's bones, which helps us make sense of the few fossils we have. Figuring out where Atrociraptor fits into the dinosaur family tree also helps us understand how dromaeosaurids, which is the group it belongs to, spread across the world. Some scientists think the whole Eudromaeosauria subgroup, which includes Atrociraptor, started in North America. This matters because it tells us how different dinosaur groups evolved and moved around over time. But while we're not sure exactly where to put it into the dinosaur family tree, one thing's clear. Atrociraptor has shaken our understanding of dinosaur evolution and shown us that incomplete fossils can make a big impact on paleontology. As seen earlier with other dinosaurs, popular culture likes to create their own versions of the animals. This is also the case when it comes to the Atrociraptor and some other dromaeosaurids. Thanks to movies like Jurassic Park and Jurassic World, we imagine both the Velociraptor and the Atrociraptor as smart, pack-hunting predators about as big as a human. But this image is more Hollywood than what science really tells us. When we compare Atrociraptor and Velociraptor, we can see some big differences in how they're portrayed in the movies compared to reality. In reality, both were much smaller than portrayed in the movies. Velociraptor was about 1.6 feet or 0.6 meters tall at the hip and 5 to 6.8 feet or 1.5 to 2 meters long, while Atrociraptor was 1.6 feet or 0.6 meters tall and 5.9 to 6.6 feet or 1.8 to 2 meters long. Some paleontologists also state that the Atrociraptor could have been even slightly smaller than this. That's because of the discussion about Atrociraptor being a closer cousin to Sauronitholestes than Velociraptor. Even so, this represents a very different picture compared to the 6.6 feet or 2 meter tall dinosaurs they show us in the movie franchise. With these realistic sizes, it makes it more likely that it would have taken a chunk of your calves rather than look you in the eye. But size wasn't the only difference between these two dromaeosaurids. Atrociraptor had a robust skull, deeper snout, and dental arrangement that suggests it might have hunted larger prey and been a specialized predator in its ecosystem. Velociraptor, on the other hand, had a much more slender-built skull. This means they probably had different hunting styles and preferred different kinds of food, which also challenges the idea that all dromaeosaurids played similar roles. They also lived in different places and times. Velociraptor lived in the deserts of southern Mongolia and northern parts of China about 75 to 71 million years ago. Atrociraptor lived a bit later, around 71 to 69.6 million years ago, in what's now Alberta, Canada. Back then, it was a lush coastal area. These different environments likely shaped how each species evolved. As we separate fact from fiction, it's clear that Atrociraptor finally deserves its own place in the spotlight. Its unique features and role in its environment show that it was more than just another raptor. The fact that Atrociraptor stuck around for over 2 million years tells us its adaptations were successful. And that's also the case for a lot of other lesser-known dinosaurs. These lesser-known species shaped the prehistoric world in ways we're still figuring out, but as with everything else in life, the more famous topics take the spotlight in popular culture. This makes it even harder for the lesser-known species to reach popularity. One of these famous dinosaurs is the Tyrannosaurus Rex, which you can learn more about in this video. Thanks for watching, and until next time.